All right, we learned a lot of problems that can happen with neural networks, and we also learned some techniques or tactics or approaches to solve these problems. But when should we use which one, and how should we even start building a neural network? How should we initialize everything? So in this exercise, I will show you some options for how to initialize your network based on the kind of problem that you have. And also we are going to experiment with changing some of the settings and see how it's going to impact the performance of the model. So I am using the same structure, the exact same structure as we used in the simple neural network exercise. Really briefly, I'll show you the code. We are reading a data set. Now I'm changing the data set. I'll show you in a second the exact data set that we're using here. In the previous exercise, in the simple exercise, we were using the digits, the MNIST digits data set. Now we're using CIFAR 10 data set. And in this one, we have objects and animals and things like that that we need to classify. And then I am creating a network as always. And then the next part is evaluating the network, seeing the performance and looking at the confusion matrix. So before we start, I will increase the font size of the code so it's easier for you to see too. All right, so I imported my libraries, and then I will just import the data set. Again, you can find this in the Keras datasets library. And we have 50,000 training examples and 10,000 testing examples. This is what the training examples look like. So it is a little bit different than the data set that we used before, because right now this is not a grayscale image. We are working with colored images. And in colored images, you have three channels, red, green, and blue. And you have different values for all of these channels. So this first array corresponds to one pixel in the image, because the first one shows us the red value, the second one shows us the green value, and the third one shows us the blue value. So that's why the data sets are a little bit bigger than when it was black and white only. And let's look at how the images look like. We have images that are 32 to 32, and they have three channels. So in total, the dimensions are 32 times 32 times 3. And here are the classes that we have. If you remember in the first examples, the classes were named just from 0 to 9, so it didn't really matter if we noted down the class names or not. But for this one, it matters because the classes now have names like airplane, automobile, bird, cat, deer, dog. And you can see the images here. We have a horse. Not really sure what this is. This is probably a deer, a car, a ship. It is named in this data set. So basically, we are trying to classify these images. And as you can see, because they are very small images, it's not really easy even for us to see. But if you make them smaller, of course, they're going to be a little bit more obvious. Just the quality is a bit bad, basically, because they're small images. And after we create the names, what we're going to do is I just want to see if we put the right word in the right place. So I'm just going to get the eighth example from our training data set and see if it's correct. Yes, okay, then it is a ship, then it's all good. And the next part is the actual interesting part where we start initializing our network, but let's do that in the next video.